We're in En Kerem, or the Spring of the Vineyard, a village which commemorates the traditional home of Zacharias and Elizabeth, the parents of John the Baptist. We remember the story from the beginning of Luke chapter 1, that Zacharias had an angel appear to him in the temple telling him that they would have a child in their old age. And they returned to their home where Elizabeth conceived and where John the Baptist was born. This is, of course, an important story framing the miraculous annunciation and conception of Jesus and Jesus' birth. At the end of chapter 1, John the Baptist is born, traditionally somewhere near this church. And when all the friends and family of Elizabeth and Zacharias gathered to welcome the baby and see him circumcised and named, Zacharias offered an inspired blessing upon his son. This is recorded beginning in Luke 1, verse 68, as the so-called Benedictus. And you can see all around the courtyard of this church plaques which have the Benedictus in all of these different languages. We're standing by the plaque which gives the Benedictus in English. I'll read a little of it from our King James Version. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has visited and redeemed his people, and hath raised up a horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David, as he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began, that we might be saved from our enemies, to perform the mercy promised to our fathers and remember his covenant. And after going on with what's effectively a messianic prophecy of the coming birth of Jesus, he then goes ahead and blesses his own son, that his son would be a prophet of the highest and go before the face of the Lord to prepare his ways. This is the beginning of our Christmas story.